there is something we need. It's a leap of faith, a step away from the comfort zone and be a little brave.
Hey guys, welcome to a brand new day. Every day holds the possibility of a miracle. You just have to get up and recognize it for what it is. Anyway, I'm here by myself to do chores because everybody else is sleeping and I hate waking up my kids. Like, never wake a sleeping child. Anyway, or husband. Anyway, I'm here to feed the horses and share a couple things with you guys. So this is our reality today. Have fun. I'm going to bring you guys in. Just don't know how it's gonna happen yet. It is raining outside and we can't put the horses in here, open it up for them because, yeah, clearly. Anyway, this is our reality. If you wanna see how high I'm 5'9", and over there, it's like above my head. There's a small path here. Yeah. So, yesterday I shared with you guys that I was a little disappointed in our hay. The quality seems good, I like that. But yeah, this is half of it. And then the other half, so we have like some nice bales, just a few, and then the rest look like this. So many have just one string. I don't know if you can see, it's just all completely misshapen and the strings are not even, they're just on a quarter of the bale, so you can hardly move them. So that's what the majority of our bales look like. Or they're totally like misshapen and like, see, I don't know if you can see, the strings are really loose because they're not on there properly. They're not in the middle of the bale. So when you pick it up, it just falls apart. This is just annoying as heck. Like, but yeah, this is it. This is 250 bales of our own hay. So as frustrating as it is to have it done poorly and to be charged a really high price, it's $3.50. Oh, and here's more. $3.50 a bale is a lot of money, which I don't mind paying as long as the quality of the work was good, and it was not. So I'm gonna deal with that today. So how I deal with things like that, things that are done distastefully or things that I find distasteful, like half-assing a job that is kind of important, is that I accept it for what it is. I'm gonna tell the guy, maybe he doesn't know that his baler's not working correctly because a lot of the hay was baled incorrectly. I'm not gonna throw a fit. I'm not gonna tell him mean things. I'm not gonna bash his name through the internet and so nobody else will hire him. I'm going to accept the job that was done. Tell him what happened kindly, and then I'm never going to use him again. So that is a natural consequence. When somebody does something terrible, natural consequences happen to all of us. So the natural consequences is that he's going to lose this job, and that's okay. Like, that's just the way the world works. What is not a natural consequence is bashing people, telling them mean things, being mean to them, all that stuff. So that's how I handle stresses and situations like that.
So take a look around you. How far can you see? How far do you think you can run? Standing on your knees. It's a beautiful world out there. Just don't pass on the dare. If you have the will and a moment to spare, it's a beautiful world out there.
I've been noticing the craziest thing with Stella, and I've been telling you guys a little bit about it, but today I went out there and I was putting on her halter and she stood stock still and she stared in my eyes and she had like the most compassionate look in her eyes, and it was for a long time, and we just stood there staring in each other's eyes, and it was like gentle and compassion. Like, that's what I saw reflected in her eyes, and I was like overwhelming. Like, I was rubbing her face and she's looking at me like she loved me. Like, I think it's happening. I think it's happening. Like, it's so crazy.
It's a beautiful world out there. It can be a bit frightening. It's something you don't know. You need a little enlightening. It'll make you grow. It's a beautiful world out there. Just don't pass on the dare. If you have the will, honey, it's a beautiful world out there.
brother looks his face.
Do you like him? Do you like riding him? Can I video you?
Sure.
They have the exact same socks on the exact same feet.
Do you guys remember Claire from the Pony Squad? Who are you riding this week in horse camp?
I'm riding Echo, Storm's half-brother.
And how do you find him?
He's a lot slower than my horse, and my horse is a baby, so she's like, zoom.
So are you saying horse? Are you saying Storm's brother is slow?
Yes. I guess it runs in the family.
Yeah, it does. So do you like riding him?
Yeah, he's super sweet.
You've never actually ridden Storm, have you?
No.
Oh, well, we'll have to figure out that. We're going to have to do a Pony Squad reunion at our barn.
Yes!
Yeah, we're going to do it.
And I'm going to ride Storm.
Yeah, because he's our easy, our nice.
You have to feed him later.
Oh, look. Did you bring him treats?
Brought him an apple.
Oh, like what a baby. Like he's like, Mama.
Wow. And this guy over here
that's
is like,
Missy. Let me out, Missy. Or maybe she's like, woohoo, boys.
Her supper.
Her breakfast?
Breakfast.
Oh, look, he got all his hay on the ground.
Oh, yeah. He does that.
So, yeah, I'm sorry, handsome. You're just here for 5 days. Do you feel the love? Your friends are all missing you. Finn's being a brat without you. Yeah, you're such a good boy.
Full, but it has poop in it.
Storm, you pooped in your bucket. Like, you've never pooped in his bucket before. Hey, were you stressed out? We brought you water from home. No, oh, he wanted a drink. See, we brought you water. It's okay. We'll always take care of you.
If you have the will and a moment to spare, it's a beautiful world out there. It's a beautiful world out there. Oh, if you have the will and a moment to spare, it's a beautiful world out there. It's a beautiful world out there.
Mom, I hung up. He's like, Storm got his grain, and I did not.
Okay. You hung up his grain?
I'm
busy. Yeah, so he can't knock it everywhere.
I'm not gonna lie, I felt like when we got there, Storm was gonna be like, take me home, I hate it here, but he seemed okay. Like, actually, I think he's the only one out of our horses that seemed okay. He's got Tex there, and he loves to go places. Like, he legit loves, I didn't even look at my hair today when I did it. Yeah, he legit does love to go places and do stuff, and today's the last day that they'll be stuck, like, at the barn all day. Tomorrow, they go cross-country schooling, so, yeah. He's having lots to eat, he has a nice big stall, and he's got his friends. So, but he did call out to us. As soon as he heard us coming, he called out to us. And I was nervous, but he was good, he's doing good. All right, so we're out shopping. Sam is buying all the stuff he still needs to fix my car. So I wanted to read a comment because this is super relevant to me. Sashi123, and I just want to say that she's been following us for a really, really, really long time. She says, oh my god, exactly, Laura. Stormy is meant for Gabby, and he is her beloved horse. She can have fun with him, trail riding, small competitions, and the most important thing is that they have an incredible bond, and she did amazing when she rode him in her lesson with Fiona. That beautiful bay gelding will teach her lots and continue to teach her in their partnership. If I was lucky enough to own an amazing horse like Storm, I would be happy to ride him on trails and have fun with him, because competing and other things are not as important as having a bond with a fantastic horse like Storm. And I wanted to read that to you guys. Thank you, Sasha, I think her name is. Thank you anyways for that comment, because that's something that I wanted to point out, is that the bond is the most important thing. Like, it's if all you have with your horse, if you go into your field and you sit down with your horse, it's 23 years old, and you think, man, it sucks that we can't do anything together. The bond is the most important thing that you can do with your horse. It's the only thing that truly matters. So if you guys, I know a lot of you guys are struggling with horses that you can't ride, go out there and do something else with your horse if you can't ride. Love the horse you have and build a bond, because that is the only thing that is the most important. All right, guys, we are back in my van. So hopefully, fingers crossed, that we do not have to call the tow truck again. Today I've been getting a lot of work done. I edited a video, did some chores around the house, and then I have two more videos that I need to edit. We have to run into town to do a couple of business appointments, and then have to go get the girl. After that, we get to do what? What are we doing, Sam? favorite thing in the world, which is what?
Hay.
Hay. We have to get all the hay out of the arena up into the barn, and our goal is to get it done by today. And then tomorrow is Sophie's day. What's happening tomorrow, Sophie?
I'm having a friend over.
It's true. Some of you guys have been like, what about poor Sophie? Sophie does not want to go to advanced camp. Sophie is not allowed to go to advanced camp. You have to be able to do certain things. And she's happy being home. She's happy to have a break from her sister. She's happy and she does stuff while we're home. And but tomorrow we're making it all about her. You guys might not know this, but Sophie is a shopaholic girl, aren't you? Mm-hmm. And so that's what she wanted, so that's what she did. She now has a bank account with a Visa debit card, so she can buy what she wants. There is something about that horse, her name is Gracie, Kaylee rides her sometimes, that makes me want her. But I'm in love with her. I'm so in love with that horse. I literally love that horse. I want to buy her so bad.
If there is something we need, it's a leap of faith, a step away from the comfort zone, and be a little brave.
You want to come home with us, Gracie girl?
And don't forget to make sure to hit that subscribe button down below.